Hello and welcome back. We are two strata deep in Dupur, our first historic site. It's pretty early for a historic site, but so far this one's been pretty chill. We'll level up soon. Are kudzu still worth XP? No. Oh no, our wire strand. Aw. Ooh, lots of baskets. And a thirst thistle. And that's enough to level us up. Do we have enough to take swipe? No, not just yet. We do have an attribute point. I think I'm going to throw that into intelligence as well. And that'll actually give us enough skill points to take swipe. And now we are on like permanent dueling stance. And we can just start swiping and lunging. We're only going to swipe if... actually, we could check out that turret upstairs. I wonder if they have a good gun. I know exactly where they are. Let's try dueling stance. Swipe. Yeah, I disarmed them. They had a musket. That's fine. Could be worse. Do we have any ammo? We do have some ammo. Actually, we have quite a bit of ammo. I mean, that's a gun. It's not a bad first gun. Could do worse. So now our tactic is... Wait, what is this? Oh, black ooze. Why are we encountering black ooze? Oh, why did I step in it? I didn't mean to do that at all. Oh, God. Wash yourselves off. I don't have anything to deal with getting sick. Stop oozing. Stop being oozy. Okay, there we go. Oh, that's gonna be annoying. Even just dealing with this right now is not great. I'm gonna go ahead and kinda break this wall. Oh, famished. Let's go ahead and eat a meal. I think the pathfinding will automatically avoid bad liquids such as black ooze. What was that? I think that was a two-headed boar. It was a two-headed boar. We can do a lunge. Of course, lunge means something different now when we're in dueling stance. So one thing I could do... I suppose I'm going to be switching from between dueling stance and defensive stance quite a bit. Because apparently I like the defensive stance lunge a lot. But, you know, it's good to discover new things that you like. And also new techniques that, you know, make life a little bit safer. I don't think you can double poison something. I guess this is something I could... experiment with. We took out that boar. They made life a little bit harder on us, I will say. Can we collect? Why? Now we're oozing again. Why did there have to be ooze on this floor? Are we clean? We're clean. Okay. Good lord, I hate this. Collect liquid. Pour this into our water skin. No. 61 drams. Oh, I see. It's gonna take a lot more than that. Just continue breaking this shale. Oh, then we were suddenly killing a hermit. Okay, we're gonna take this brackish ooze, pour nearby. There. Do it. Okay. They're willing to walk through the ooze, wade through this ooze to get me. And you know what? Power to them. I wonder if I do a lunge, if I will be over, if I'll like basically jump back over that puddle. Let's try it. Am I still in defensive? Yeah, I am. Yeah, it looks like I just jump over that ooze, which is kind of nice. Why is there ooze here? Oh God, can you guys please stop? collect liquid, pour. Blood is salty, water skin. This is how you play this game safely, by the way. I ain't starting episode 4 with, how are we gonna cure our horrible disease? You know, that's not happening. No. I guess I do want to pour it out. Tea, pour, nearby, there. Go ahead. Done. Okay, did I just walk over more stuff? I guess I was oozy a little bit. Why is there so much black ooze on this floor? This is awful. Human corpse. Oh, I hate this. I'm leaving this floor now. What do you mean there's a Golgatha section to this historic site? There's a seed worm. Those are quite rare. We have acid. Flaming Tor is broken. We have kudzu. This is a nightmare site. I mean, I hesitate to say it, but it still could be worse, to be honest. There's still things that I'm not seeing, and I'm grateful for that. Shrine to Oridates, 2206, Oridates desiccated progeny of vines, leaf, and corn silk. The Dupur Terror died of natural causes. She was 97 years old. One of our daggers rusted. That's fine. I should have collected that sap. We can collect that sap. You never know. You never know when sap is going to be the cure to a disease. I don't play around with that anymore. Really don't want to explore this site, to be honest. Not sure if... Oh, there's our item. Traveling Sphere of Dupur. Collect the cybernetic credit wedge. I'm also gonna grab this chest. And I'm actually just gonna leave. I don't wanna be here anymore. There might be more here. I'll come back later when I have recipes to deal with such horrifying disease ridden mess, but we found a ruin. I kind of want to just go to our 6-day stilt just to I was about to say to make a checkpoint. That's not a thing. that feeling is sinking in. Well, we can trade some stuff. We have some stuff to look at. Freezing bronze dagger. We have... Is this our first chem cell? Yes, it is. And apparently that other cell was the one I broke. Is this broken? Yeah, it is broken. We know it's a chem cell now. Let's look at our... Is it armor? What is it that we just got? Miscellaneous? Yeah, Traveling Sphere of Dupur. What does it do? Oh my god! Electrical resistance, move speed, carry capacity. Could be better, to be honest. I've seen a far better sphere than this, but extra move speed is kind of hilarious. It actually kind of makes this worse in a way, because it's like, if that was anything else. Actually, this is kind of an awful item. The electrical resistance is nice, I'll say that. But outside of that, I'm not a huge fan. There's our Reshef lore. Free Reshef lore. correction. Free Reshef lore. I'm gonna go ahead and fully explore R6D still to see what kind of, what was that? Oh, a Glover, okay. Glover, my favorite N64 game. I tell a lie, I've actually never played it. More Reshef lore. A correction, free Reshef lore. Okay. We have a bookbinder. We have an Ichor merchant. You have anything good? You have some neutron flux on you. We're nowhere near being able to afford this or even like scam them. A shame, but hey, we have an Ichor merchant. And 5272 Mupater won a decisive victory against the combined forces of Darsipur at the bloody battle of Duyalimu, though she lost her prized breastplate's foe during the course of the conflict. As a result of the battle, Duyalimu was so rife with smashed rubble that it was renamed Mighty Wastes. That's a nice one, and we have our quest to visit that site and also recover the breastplate, which is good. That was a very good little bit of lore that we just collected. You're famished. That's fine. I'm just exploring the 60 still. Ooh, we have our first schematic salesman. Of course, I'm not gonna know anything that they have. I'm working on our intelligence side. Actually, do we really need tinkering? I mean, the answer is yes, of course. But tinkering seems less important if we have a natural weapon. But there are other things that we want to tinker. We do have a gunsmith. We could buy some ammo. Oh, that's a grenadier. A grenadier. Alright, well, that's cool. We only have one skim seller. We have a Glover, we have a Hatter. They seem quite mad. Go to our Kipper. What do you got? Anything good? I wouldn't say no to some congealed love. Doesn't look like you have it. Okay, well, let's check out what the Glover has, because it's this early in the game. Oh, well, we've got some more. Oh, we already knew that. That was the breastplate. Ooh. In 6139, Oridates II won the decisive victory against the combined forces of Kamish at the bloody battle of Uramas Tangle, though he lost his prized Nuptialuka swine gift. During the course of the conflict, as a result of the battle, Uramas Tangle was so rife with stray portals to other places and times that it was renamed Boundless Void. That's a good one. And we've got another historic site, and we've got another quest to recover a historic item. Quite good. We're making great gains in terms of our lore. It's always worth exploring your 6-day stilt. And apparently, I mean, if you're really inclined... Ooh, we have another Ichor merchant? What do you have? Primordial ooze. You got a painted glass. It's even worth, like, if you are so inclined to visit all of your merchants, even the ones that don't matter, like the Hatters and the Glovers and the Booters, you know? Because they all have... They potentially have painted and engraved goods. And that's really valuable in the early game, IMO. Congealed shade oil, meh. I wouldn't say no to a salve injector, though. We're gonna sell this pocketed vest. That's the only reason I took it. And these goggles, we'll sell those goggles. We have night vision, so we don't really care about that. And I guess a lot of our goods got rusted, but we'll sell them nonetheless. We'll sell this chrome revolver. I'm not too worried about keeping things to break them down. Ah, shoot. I should have maybe used that fix-it spray foam on the bronze ingot. Well, that'll have to do. We could stand to sell something. Wow, a lot of our stuff got rusted. That sucks. We'll sell a little bit of kudzu stem just for some extra water. And that's pretty much it. Now, I won't lie, I'm a little bit tempted to hand in our Reshef lore right now just to get to level 10. And since this is not a roleplay mode, then I think it's actually worth doing this, even though the correct play is to hand it in later. But I would like to get to level 10 just so we get another rapid advancement. Except 3700 XP, we get to level 10. Oh, do we not get a rapid advancement at level 10? Or is it... Oh, I guess it's like at level 5 and then every 10 levels after that. So we're going to get it at level 15. Oh, bummer. Oh, well. That's fine. So at this point, I wouldn't mind exploring our Six Days Tilt. Or not... Sorry, not Six Days Tilt. Our Sand Desert. So I might fill the rest of this episode with... this, but the next episode it'll basically be a highlight reel of like everything we find at the Six Days Tilt. I'm gonna be trying to level up a little bit. I'm gonna be playing this game like really cautiously because I want to win. I want to win, and I want to see the new content. I want to explore the Moonstair. I want to break new ground. This is the one. This is the one. And you know, I'm not ignorant to the fact that I might get a little bit of bad luck. Maybe this run is cursed. But I'm really enjoying this build, and I think I'm playing it well. So I'm happy with what we're doing for now. I'm gonna collect some daggers, but yeah, we're just gonna be doing this for the rest of this episode, and then I'll do a highlight reel in the next episode. But yeah, we're gonna be collecting a lot of daggers. I mean, like, playing Caves of Cud really cautiously means doing some, you know, low-key stuff. Like, I enjoy this, but I also understand that it's not super enjoyable to watch. Not going to be dealing with Dawn Gliders. That is a nasty tile. I'm actually going to make a note of this tile. Is that going to be robot reputation? Loved by Pewtus Templar. Doesn't look like they have any robot rep. I am going to make a note of this in my journal. Insert ad. Legend Pewtus. I don't think that they'll have anything. If they were an actual legend Pewtus Templar, they would have like tonics and stuff, and possibly a Eater's Nectar injector. That would be really nice, but they don't. So I'm just gonna go ahead and avoid that tile for now. But I'm gonna make sure that I'm doing things right. I do want to collect everything. Oh, we got our first rifler. They could do some nasty damage. So I'm actually gonna back away, and we're gonna exploit this a little bit. Oh. Kill. Is that our first? That's our first Isakari rifle. We'll actually equip that. And the Isakari rifle is a little bit better. Actually, it's a lot better. I don't know what I'm saying. It's a lot better than the musket. And then we go to our left because this is the actual tile we're on. In fact, yeah, this is the tile we're on. So we're gonna go down, check our left and our right. This is how I do things, how I check two tiles at the same time. we come in and the tile, if there's a range, if there's a rifler, they have the potential to really do some nasty damage to you. So I don't really want to mess with them. I actually fear them in some ways in the early game more than Dawn Gliders because they're unpredictable. Like they can crit you really nasty. Whereas Dawn Gliders are pretty predictable. Okay, so we've got a legendary Dawn, or not Dawn Glider. Legend Bark Glider. I'm not gonna take this guy on. He's gonna be too tough for me. Well, let's have a look at him. Loved by bears, disliked by grazing hedonists, hated by the villagers of Kikyuka. Well, I don't know if actually they're worth killing or making friends with, to be honest. Hungry. Oh, is that a Barathermite? Yes, it is. Nice. What is your rep? Loved by Barathermites, hated by the sight seekers of a sightless way. Oh, that sucks, actually. I would like to make friends with the seekers of a sightless way. Barathermite rep is quite easy to get. So I'm actually going to make a note of this. And this is a potential candidate to make enemies with. Legend Barath. Seeker rep. So I'm making a note of things. Do they have some things to trade? I mean, they do, but I don't know. I have no idea what you have. Ooh, a rust bog. Heck yeah, bud. With two chests? Heck yeah, that's exactly what we want. I'm going to take these chests as well. I'll rust you, locker. Yeah, we'll take these chests. Loving the carrying capacity we have. Ooh, that is a very heavy box that we just picked up. I don't think we need another chest. Ellen, I think what I do want to do, I'm going to take one more chest. Something I would like to do is actually, we've got a couple salve injectors. What I'd like to do is take a couple of these and put them in a box. Actually, I'm going to drop this box. I guess having too many boxes is kind of a problem. No, it's not a problem because you might not know what I'm doing here, but basically I'm safeguarding a couple of salves in case we ever become confused or we're put in a really bad situation where we don't know what our stuff is. And that way, if you are holding a locker or some kind of chest or box that has tonics, then you know when you're looking through your items, based on the dialogue that opens up. Like if you look at your hermer her and woohoo and boo, you know, like it'll tell you apply, eat, and open. So we will know, oh, this is a box because I can open it, and inside is the tonic that I hit and apply it, and you can reliably apply healing. Oh my goodness, another rust bog. Pinch me. My goodness, we've got a security card. We've got some more goodies, even more goodies. Ooh, 75 pounds for this one. We can't hold that. In fact, we can't hold this either. But I'm gonna grab it anyway. Do we have something we can drop? I guess we could drop these magnetized boots, which really sucks, but I was only carrying them because I wanted to disassemble them later. I guess we could drop this chem cell. I don't think I'm gonna use it since it's broken. This small stone is for sure I'm gonna say it's a recoiler for Grit Gate. Kyakyukya. Whoa, that's a weird one. Okay. I was kind of hoping it was a Grit Gate recoiler, because then we could go to straight to Grit Gate and then recoil back out to Joppa. So we didn't have to, we could just skip the entire journey to Grit Gate. That's how much I hate that journey, by the way. Now, if we do encounter a Dromad caravan, there is a pretty good chance that we can do that anyway, because it's a very strange quirk that Dromad caravans explore later. Dromad caravans tend to have a lot of they tend to have Grit Gate recoilers. Don't know why. Grit Gate seems to be a very popular place, despite the fact that they don't actually let anyone in. Okay, well, this is that is Dawn Glider Central. We don't want to deal with that. Continuing down. No riflers here. We'll get some extra XP here. Yeah, there's no riflers here. Come here. Why are you running? Oh, you had an acid gas grenade. Good for you, bud. I didn't see that one coming, honestly. Wow, you had a jewel-encrusted dagger. Oh, I can't pick up any of this. Well, I'm gonna pick up the jewel-encrusted dagger and we'll find another thing to drop. I guess I have too much stuff now. I'm gonna have to go and... We'll just eat a kudzu stem. Yummy. Where are we? We're not even halfway down. This has been a very fruitful salt desert so far. Let's go back to the six-day still and see if we can't make some money. Oh, you know what? We could... I guess I could sit down and try and decipher these artifacts. Spiral borer! Oh my goodness! I love to find a spiral borer. That is amazing. And a force bracelet. Good God. We definitely wear that. Gaslight Chris is actually a really nice find as well. I think it's, I can't remember what it was. Is it the other one that's the long blade? Gonna remove the chemsel. What is this? This counts as a short blade. No, right now it's a cudgel. Always forget about that. We have another gaslight Chris, which is powered. This is a short blade. Okay. Replace and remove the chemsel. We'll need that for later. Spiky ball, huh? Oh, I broke it. Gaslight Flissa. So we actually have the long blade. We have the Gaslight Long Blade. What are the stats on this? 9 and 1d8 versus 8 and 1d8. It's only barely better. Precinct Navigator. We have a Precinct Navigator this early in the game. I could not be happier. What do you mean our Force Bracelet was unequipped? Do we have two Force Bracelets? We do. Good God. Go ahead and throw a force bracelet on there. That'll be a very good escape, should the worst happen. Siphon baton. I'm pretty sure this is really good bits, but we're not really at that stage yet, so I might check out our Ichor merchant if I can find them, and then we probably don't have enough to buy anything actually. But I'll tell you what I am gonna do is I'm gonna put our spiral borer down. Oh, I didn't fully loot that rust bog, did I? I wish I knew what the spiky ball was. Tools. Dropping this spiral borer. Missile weapons. We're gonna you know what? Actually, grab that. We're putting down a chest. That's where we're at right now. Drop this. Put some stuff in here. Let's start with magnetized boots. I'll disassemble those later. Scaled woven tunic. We don't need that right now. come back to the spiky ball. Oh, we don't need any torches. I mean, I straight up don't need them. I can just throw them away. And I'm just going to throw all of this stuff in there, and we're going to continue looting the desert. Our muskets. This stuff. Spiral borer. Bronze ingot. I'll probably spend a fix-it spray foam to repair that. And look at that. We're back in action. We're Looney Tunes back in action. Where's our rust bog? Okay, southwest. There was still stuff to loot here, so I want to grab that. Yeah. Ooh, 75 pounds. What the heck is this? I better not examine it now, because I'll break it. We'll go here, but just as a means. Oh, we should wait till... Ah, there's Dawn Gliders on that screen. Easy to tell with the new animations. Okay. Dawn Gliders there in a not great way. Not great setup for Dawn Gliders there. Wouldn't be a bad idea to take cooking and gathering. Where are we? Oh, we don't have enough skill points. We do have enough to take a new mental or mutation. That's tempting. Not sure what I want. I mean, I want precognition. I want precognition. That would be amazing. I don't know if we'll get it. There's plenty of other things I wouldn't mind having instead. Electrical generation would be fantastic, for example. I would take light manipulation. I would take any number of things, but precognition is kind of the dream, because then I can start just eating neutron flux by the bucket load. Wow. Okay, we've got... we've got spiders. Now, we're not friends with them right now, and this is one of the reasons I wish that the stinger would, our reputation would scale with the stinger. But hey, can't have everything. Web-toed Scorpiok. I don't know if I've seen that one before. We have a legendary Gershling, and they are loved by arachnids in the Gersh. Disliked by the villagers of Joppa. All the same, I think we could make friends with this one later. Legend spider. So that's kind of nice. Ooh, a village. First village. Discover the village of Subamrod. Nice. Wonder if they have a tinkerer. I don't think they do. Let's see if you do. Guys have any work? Hark, friend! There was a time where my friend would, my kind would spend all our time swallowing insects, but after hearing of the goodness of the people, we changed our habits and consecrated new ceremonies. Unfortunately, our implant sanctified skill soft plus single weapon fighting was stolen from us. We need someone to recover it, friend. Will you do it? We hear it has been taken to the workshop of TRM Legendary Haberdasher. Why couldn't you be any other haberdasher? That's fine. Any legendary merchant would be good. So actually, this is a fantastic quest. Love that. We are at the end of our episode. It's a good place to end it. And oh my goodness, you guys have a freaking gel, a entropic gel as your warden. Ludicrous. Absolutely incredible warden. You guys are safe forever. Okay, well, anyway, if you are enjoying the series, definitely hit the like button and consider subscribing for more content like this. I'll see you guys next time. Take it easy.